I was in the attic and I found a couple of boxes that belonged to your great-grandfather, so I left them for you to go through. I know you'll be able to find something cool in there. Anyway, I'll be home around 11 and I'll see you then.
Thank you. We cross.
Feels like a lifetime ago since I've experienced the lynching of Adeline Belle. Let me explain. In the late 1800s, Adeline Belle opened a small shop to sell antiques and rarities. Upon establishing her reputation of providing the townspeople with interesting antiques, Belle began receiving heaps of backlash after an incident involving one of her customers. A young woman was drowned during a storm while wearing an antique dress purchased from Adeline's shop, leading family and friends to believe that the dress had been cursed. Accusations led to Adeline's condemnation and a sentencing to the bent neck punishment. On July 16, 1897, Adeline Belle was lynched by the town folk. I witnessed it all as a young child. I knew she was innocent. I knew she would never do such a thing as cursing the items she sold. But my opinion was worthless. I saw her get hanged that day. I saw everything. As she let out her final breath, I heard her leave a curse.
As my last drop of blood bleeds, I will become one with my antiques.
As she bled into the amulet in her palm, it seemingly gave her the power to live through her antiques, bringing death upon anyone who possessed one. Years went on, and her curses prevailed, taking the lives of anyone who had possession of her rarities. But no one could stop it. I found, from my own research, that Adeline's presence is palpable through the door of the dead, a portal between the overworld and the dimension of the dead. You may see the door appear in the room you are in, only if you possess one of her antiques. I was able to prevent my fate simply by